We're going to talk about binocular visual dysfunction and how to assess for it and why it is important in post-concussion rehabilitation. This month in the United States is Traumatic Brain Injury Awareness Month, and obviously we're sharing a lot of stuff about this because we're a brain-based education company. We care a lot about brains, and concussion often is, I think, underappreciated for the potential long-term effects. There's a ton of research on this. I've done a ton of blogs on it. Let's just agree that if you have a good concussion, it's possible for you to have problems for a really long time afterwards. They might be subtle, but they can be problematic, particularly if you're an athlete trying to return to play, you're a high-level executive trying to concentrate at work. Well, what we know is that concussions have long-standing symptoms in many cases, and in the research literature, one of the most classic long-term problems is problems with vision. So if we look into this really carefully, or very quickly, I should say, not carefully because that would take longer, but if we go quickly, we have two eyes, which means that our brain's receiving two images. We have two camera lenses. Your brain needs to be able to harmonize those images, and it also needs to make sure that the eyes can work together congruently. So whenever they are unable to do that, that is called binocular visual dysfunction. That can impact us tremendously in terms of our depth perception, our movement accuracy. It can cause tons of different pain issues, from headaches to neck pain, shoulder pain, back pain. It can create balance problems, create deficits in sports performance, you name it. Binocular vision dysfunction is a big deal. So the question becomes, how do I know if maybe I have this? Well, there are a ton of tests. You can see your optometrist about it, and you should. If you have any questions about your eyes, make sure, number one, that your eyes are relatively healthy. Go get an eye exam. If you have access to a behavioral optometrist or a neurooptometrist in your area, see them. They're great at doing all these kind of advanced assessments, but there are things that you can do right now. I'm gonna show them to you, and it will give you a lot of insight into your eyes and also your client's eyes to go, maybe we really need to get focused on this as a part of their post-concussion rehab. So the first thing we're gonna talk about is called the uncover test. This is a very, very simple idea, but whenever we have a brain injury, it is possible for the nerves that control the muscles that surround our eyes, we have what are called extraocular outside, extraocular muscles, that should coordinate well so that our eyes can come together, move apart, we can move them synchronously up and down, right and left, etc. When those muscles become unbalanced, however, we can see small shifts, and they are called phorias, and that can be really problematic because even a small misalignment of the eye can cause ongoing problems for the brain to be able to really understand the images that it's seeing and lead to all the stuff that we were talking about from pain and performance issues. So the uncover test is really cool, it's really simple, and you can perform it on yourself. Here's how you do it. You're gonna take your camera, your phone, you're gonna hold it up in front of you, and you're gonna stare directly at the lens, all right? You have to be staring at the lens. Now, as you're staring at the lens, what you're gonna do is you're gonna cover one eye, and you're gonna keep staring at the lens. Even though this eye can no longer see it now, I'm imagining that I'm staring at the lens of the camera. Now, at some point, you're going to uncover that eye. And here's what we're looking for. If the eye has imbalanced muscular control, it may do something like drift out, or drift in, or drift up, or down. It can be what's called exophoric, esophoric, hyperphoric, hypophoric. Now, what will happen is, because now, if my eyes are working together, and I'm looking at my camera lens, without that eye covered, I'm able to keep it aligned. But when I take it offline, meaning I'm now taking it out of use for that visual picture, the muscular imbalances will take over and the eye will begin to drift. So if I have an exophoric eye, here's what will happen. I'm looking at the lens, I cover it, my eye does this. So then when I remove the cover, the eye will have to shift back to the midline in order to rejoin the other eye in looking at the lens. That's what you're looking for. You're looking for a quick recovery movement when the eye is uncovered. That's called the uncover test. You can do it 4 or 5 times on each eye because sometimes people are great on the first rep, but then you keep challenging the eye and it fatigues. The fatigue is really, really common post-concussion. So I normally do 5 to 6 uncovers on each eye. You have to test both of them. If you see that, good possibility that you're gonna have some ongoing issues with binocular visual dysfunction. Now, our another test that we can do is our basic pencil push-up test. We take a pen or a pencil, we put it out in front of us at arm's length, we focus on the tip, and then we bring it in all the way to our nose, hopefully, and we hold it there for about 5 seconds, and then we follow it back out. This is another test of the muscular coordination. We are trying to converge our eyes, bring them together, and then diverge our eyes symmetrically. Someone that has a severe disruption of the muscular balance may have something that looks like this. They'll bring the, they're in, they're converged, and one eye will suddenly go whoop and no longer participate in the activity. If you keep watching, I'm gonna put a little video up of one of our former staff members who had some really severe exophoric issues when we first started working with him. It's a great video, and it will clearly demonstrate to you exactly what we're talking about. So if you see that in yourself or in your clients, just understand that this may mean that you need to start addressing the visual system with more exercises. And also, like I said, obviously seeing a professional that can help you with that, whether that's a neurooptometrist, behavioral optometrist, or an advanced e-health practitioner, because we start covering this stuff in our core certifications. Now, binocular visual dysfunction in post-concussion is incredibly common. It needs to be assessed, it needs to be addressed, and more importantly, it needs to be understood by movement professionals. What are the different ramifications? If I said, take a history and tell me out of that person's history things that might indicate that they have binocular visual dysfunction, you should be able to do that if you're a movement professional. To help you with that, I wrote a little ebook. We're gonna make it available to you. It's free. There's gonna be a link in the, whatever they put in YouTube, that thing down below. The message, you can click on that link and give us your email. We will send you that PDF. It's a really great fast read, and it's also great to share with your clients so they can understand, why in the heck are you doing these weird eye tests on me? What does it mean for me? Why is it important? Remember that in concussion, the longest standing problems that we see are visual and vestibular deficits, with visual leading the way. And one of the most common deficits that we see is binocular visual dysfunction. So if you were involved in traumatic brain injury rehabilitation at all, you better know this stuff. And you want to have a great referral network as well, because if it's really severe, it's going to be a team effort to get this fixed. Hope you found this enjoyable, found it interesting. If you're new to Z, we are obviously a brain-based education company. We have free courses, et cetera. So subscribe to the channel, ask us questions, check us out, see if there's, if what we do resonates with what you do, because we are super interested in sharing cutting-edge neuroscience with movement pros to help make their lives and their clients' lives better. All right, take care.